Now let's see some problems where we will apply these four formulas and we'll find out the answer as required. So the first sum is expand cos raised to 7 theta in terms of cosine of multiple of theta. So here you all can see that we have to expand this power term, power of trigonometric ratios, in terms of multiples of theta. So here we'll apply the previous method. So for that reason, I'll consider a complex number, let's say x, which is cos theta plus I sin theta. So therefore I get 1 upon x as cos theta minus I sin theta. Similarly, we'll consider power of this complex number, which will become cos of n theta plus I sin n theta by de Moivre's theorem, and 1 upon x raised to n will give me cos of n theta minus I sin n theta. Now we will find out summation of it. So it will give me x plus 1 upon x as 2 cos theta, and x raised to n plus 1 upon x raised to n as 2 cos n theta. Now I am only considering the cos terms because I want answer as multiples of cosines of theta. So I want only cos terms in the answer. Now let's start with the given question. Now the given question is cos raised to 7 theta. Now we can write down this cos raised to 7 theta as cos theta whole raised to 7. Now from the relation x plus 1 upon x equal to 2 cos theta, we can easily find out cos theta. So this 2 will go on the left hand side and it will become 1 by 2 x plus 1 upon x, and I will substitute that value in the bracket. Now we have to find 7th power of this term. Now as 1 upon 2 is the constant, I will find the 7th power separately. So this will become 1 raised to 7 as 1, 2 raised to 7 as it is. And here I will apply binomial theorem to find out the 7th power. So by binomial theorem, it will give me x raised to 7 plus 7c1 x raised to 6 1 upon x plus 7c2 x raised to 5 1 upon x square plus 7c3 x raised to 4 1 upon x cube plus 7c4 x raised to 3 1 upon x raised to 4 plus 7c5 x raised to 2 1 upon x raised to 5 plus 7c6 x into 1 upon x raised to 6 plus 7c7 into 1 upon x raised to 7. So here I have applied binomial theorem. Now we will find out the values of 7c1, 7c2, 7c3 from calculator, and here we will cancel out x terms wherever it is possible. So here x goes and x goes, we'll get x raised to 5, here we'll get x cube, here we'll get only x, here we'll get 1 upon x, here we'll get 1 upon x cube, next here we'll get 1 upon x raised to 5, and 1 upon x raised to 7 will remain as it is. And for these values we will use calculator. So therefore cos raised to 7 theta will give me, now first term was 1 upon 2 raised to 7. Now we all know that 1 upon 2 raised to 7 is 128. Now I'll write down the remaining terms. The first term was x raised to 7. Next, second term was 7c1. 7c1 is 7 into, now we'll see the previous result. So it was x raised to 5. So we'll get 7 into x raised to 5. Next, 7c2. 7c2 is 21. So 21 into x cube. So we will get x raised to 5 plus 21 x cube. Now next term, 7c3. Now we all know that 7c3 is 35. So 35 into x, so it becomes 35x. Similarly, next term is 7c4, which is again 35. 35 into 1 upon x raised to 4. Sorry, 35, this 3 and 3 gets cancelled out. So we get 35 into 1 upon x, that is 35 by x. Next term, 7c5, which will give me again 21. So 21, and here we will get 1 upon x cube. So we get 21 upon x cube plus next term 7c6, which is again 7 into 1 upon x raised to 5. So 7 upon x raised to 5, and last term will give me 1 upon x raised to 7. So this is the values. Now what we will do is we will take the terms having similar power together. So 1 upon 128 is outside. Now you can see here x raised to 7 and 1 upon x raised to 7. Here x has power as 7. We'll take it together. So x raised to 7 plus 1 upon x raised to 7 together. Next, 7 x raised to 5 and 7 upon x raised to 5. We can take 7 common. We'll get x raised to 5 plus 1 upon x raised to 5 in the bracket. Similarly, 21 x cube plus 1 upon x cube. And similarly, we will get 35 into x plus 1 upon x. Now, we will apply a formula which we have derived on the previous page. Here you can see that we have derived that x raised to n plus 1 upon x raised to n is 2 cos n theta. So therefore, x raised to 7 plus 1 upon x raised to 7 will give me 2 cos 7 theta. It means here the value of n is 7. So in the result, we will get n as 7. So 2 cos 7 theta. Similarly, we will solve remaining terms. So here I am getting 2 cos 7 theta. This term will give me 7 outside. This term will give me 2 cos 5 theta. Again 21 outside. This term will give me 2 cos 3 theta plus 35 outside. This term will give me 2 cos theta. Now we can take 2 outside the bracket because it is common everywhere. So I am taking 2 outside, and in the bracket we'll get cos of 7 theta plus 7 of cos 5 theta plus 21 cos 3 theta plus 35 cos theta. Next, here we will get 1 upon 64 into cos of 7 theta plus 7 cos 5 theta plus 21 cos 3 theta plus 35 cos theta. And you can see here that I have converted this power of trigonometric ratios in terms of multiples of theta. So I am getting cosines of multiples of theta at each term. So that's it.